that Michelle, you know, she's got a dazzling smile. Yeah. I mean, I understand there's in terms of popularity, there's basically Michelle, Malia, Sasha, Sunny, our dog, then me. I understand. She's hot. She's smart. She is. She's charming. She's intelligent. I get it. But here's a little secret about Michelle. You know, in our household, she can be a little bit of the glass half empty person sometimes. You know, she can get a little discouraged about what she sees happening. And you know, I'm the hope and change guy. So I'm usually a little more optimistic. And so if she's been watching the news or reading the papers and some crazy stuff is taking place, which is basically every 10 minutes, you know, she can get a little down and I'll say, hey, honey, everything's gonna be okay. And I believe that. I believe things will be okay. But I also know that things won't be okay on their own. They'll be okay if we make the effort. It'll be okay if we work for it, not just on election day, but every day in between. And I know, look, I know some of you probably feel like Michelle does sometimes, because I feel, even me, the hope and change guy, I can get discouraged. Politics is so nasty and mean, and it just seems like people will say anything and do anything. And it can be depressing sometimes. And a lot of what we used to take for granted, things like respect and common decency and telling the truth and believing in science and the idea that every vote should count and that the person with the most votes win. All that somehow has become controversial. But I was listening backstage to what Josh talked about, the experience of him running for governor and traveling around the state. And it reminded me of the experience that I had first as a state senator traveling around my district, and then as a U.S. Senate candidate in Illinois, and then as a presidential candidate. It's such a privilege to be able to meet people from every walk of life, folks who look different and live in different places. And it would always remind me, and what we have to remind ourselves, is that there's this common thread. There's this thing that binds us together as Americans. A belief that no matter who we are or where we come from, what we look like, who we love, what our last name is, how we worship, a belief that all of us matter. The kind of slash and burn politics that we're seeing right now, that doesn't have to be who we are. We can be better. And it has nothing to do, by the way, with political correctness or being too woke. It's about fundamental values that my grandparents from Kansas taught me. Values I grew up with, values you grew up with, values we try to teach our kids, values we learn in churches and mosques and synagogues and temples. Honesty, fairness, opportunity, hard work. Values that Josh Shapiro and John Fetterman stand for. Values that Joe Biden stands for. Values that were enshrined in our founding documents a few miles from here. A clarion call for freedom and equality that Philly's own Liberty Bell represents. That's what America stands for. That's who we are. So if you're anxious and frustrated right now, don't complain, don't mope, don't tune out. Get off your couch and do what? Put down your phones and do what? Vote for Josh Shapiro. Vote for John Fetterman. Vote for leaders who will fight for you and your families. Vote for folks who will fight for that big, inclusive, hopeful, forward-looking America that we believe in. Who will work with Joe Biden to build a country that is more fair and more just and more equal and more free. That's our task. Let's get to work. I love you, Philly.